Today is going to be a great day. I am Nikki G, your host. Welcome to the Lone Doctrine, the food for thought exploration station, and your place in making today better than yesterday. We keep it short, simple, actionable, and practical. This month, we've been talking about the concept of filling your cup. In a way, giving to yourself in order to assure you can fully and genuinely give to others is an ongoing process. What are you doing to fill your cup each and every day? Last time we explored the importance of filling your cup and how it's just as an empty lantern provides no light. Filling your lantern allows your light to shine brightly. How many metaphors can we come up with? If you have a good one, let me know on Instagram at Lone Doctrine. I always come up with the strangest, weirdest, but sometimes good metaphors and analogies, and I love hearing other people's renditions. I'll give you a shout out if you send me one. Back to the topic at hand, it's that time of year for giving, but this year we're going to make sure you're also giving to yourself. More often than not, when I discuss this topic with other people or even explore this topic on my own, one root that consistently stands steady in that is that when we're thinking of the concept of filling our cup, what comes to mind is most people are worried about what other people will think. Will they think I'm selfish or too good for them? What if my life looks this way and theirs look that way? The comparing game, as I mentioned before, is at an all-time high. So let's break this down to the root and explore that life is enough and it's time to stop comparing yourself to others by Zen Habits. Enjoy your own life without comparing it with that of another. If you took the strengths of others and compared them to your weaknesses, how do you think you'd size up? And do you think this would make you feel good? The funny thing is, this is what most of us do at one point or another, and some of us do it pretty often. It's a surefire recipe for a drop in self-confidence and for unhappiness. It's also not that useful. Let's say I took a look at someone who creates amazing artwork and really top-notch podcasts on their website, and I look at my art and my video skills and realize I don't come close to measuring up. In fact, I look pretty pitiful. I'm a lousy drawer and I don't know anything about podcasting. But wait a minute. It's not a fair comparison. Just because I don't measure up doesn't mean I should get out of the art business or out of the podcasting business or that I should get depressed or jealous or resentful. Instead, if I looked at my strengths, writing useful and honest podcasts, I can see that I have a lot to offer, a lot to be happy about. And that's so important, being able to look at your own strengths and see your true value. It's actually one of the keys to success because without this ability, you will be unmotivated and won't believe in yourself. A quick tip of advice is when you find yourself comparing to others, once you develop this awareness, try to flip the script. Tell yourself to stop. Set up processes to block those people or do what you can to not put yourself in a position of this constant comparison. And then start thinking about all the things you do have, the things that you love, the people you have, the blessings that life has given you. Make this a regular practice and you'll start to be happier with your own life. But let's take a look for a moment at what's wrong with comparing yourself to others. Like I said, it's usually an unfair comparison to start with. As a result, you'll always come off bad if you look at someone's strengths, including what they have, like houses and cars, and your weaknesses. Even if you compare your strength to a strength, there will always be those who are better and those who are worse. Where you are on the ladder of accomplishments or purchases has nothing to do with what you want to do. Even if you do well in comparison with others, you may be artificially inflated from the comparison. It's a short-lived boost of ego if you win the comparison, you will be easily knocked down. You end up resenting others for doing well without really knowing the true person or the true story. You can see this if you're ever resented someone upon first meeting them and then later realized you got the wrong idea. When you find yourself in constant comparison, you might end up talking about your own accomplishments more than necessary, being and feeling somewhat insecure. You might criticize someone in public, trying to knock them down, often unfairly. These aren't good qualities. Let's look at how to stop this crazy comparison phenomenon. First, just become aware. Most often, we do these social comparisons without realizing we're doing it. It's a natural act, I suppose, and as the result, it's something that is done without consciousness. So the solution is to become conscious. Bring these thoughts to the forefront of your consciousness by being on the lookout for them. If you focus on these thoughts for a few days, it gets much easier with practice, and soon it'll be hard to notice. Stop yourself. Once you realize you're doing these comparisons, give yourself a pause. Don't berate yourself or feel bad. Just acknowledge the thought and gently change your focus. And then count your blessings. A better focus is on what you do have, what you are already blessed with. Count what you have, not what you don't. Think about how lucky you are to have what you have, to have the people in your life who care about you, to be alive at all. Focus on those strengths. Instead of looking at your weaknesses, ask yourself what your strengths are. Celebrate them. Be proud of them. Don't brag, but feel good about them and work on using them to your best advantage. And be okay with imperfection. No one is perfect. Intellectually, we all know that, but emotionally, we seem to feel bad when we don't reach perfection. You aren't perfect, and you never will be. And I say that with love. I certainly am not, and I've learned to be okay with that. Sure, keep trying to improve, but don't think you'll ever be that perfect person. If you look at it in a different way, that imperfection is what makes you who you are. You're already perfect. And in the process, don't try and knock others down. Sometimes we try to criticize others just to make ourselves look or feel better. Taking someone else down for your benefit is destructive. It forms an enemy when you could be forming a friend. In the end, that hurts you as well. Instead, try to support others in their success. That will lead to more success on your part as well. We should be lifting each other up, not pushing each other down. And focus on the journey. Don't focus on how you rank in comparison to others. Life is not a competition. It's a journey. We are all on a journey to find something, to become something, to learn, to create. That journey has nothing to do with how well other people are doing or what they have. It has everything to do with what we want to do and where we want to go. That's all you need to worry about. And learn to love enough. If you always want what others have, you will never have enough. You will always want more. That's an endless cycle, and it will never lead to happiness. No matter how many clothes you buy, no matter how many houses you own, no matter how many fancy cars you acquire, you'll never have enough. Instead, learn to realize that what you have is already enough. If you have shelter over your head, food on your table, clothes on your back, and people who love you, you are blessed. You have enough. Anything that you have over and above that, which if you take a moment to think about it, you probably do, is more than enough. Be good with that and you'll find contentment. To love is to stop comparing. Our lives can quickly be consumed by comparison, and before we know it, we're the farthest supporter from our own self. We're so busy setting up camp in our lack, which is a mirage when in comparison, because we really don't know the whole story most of the time. And before we know it, we're neglecting our own well-being. In filling your cup, it's time to step aside. Focus on your life. And that doesn't mean you ignore everyone in the process, but look around and collect good people. Find those who will encourage you to fill your cup, who will lift you up and not drain your cup or poke holes, constantly leaving you drained. That is what we will be exploring next week as you start to make the small changes towards being your best self. Who and what are you surrounding yourself with? But until then, rewind to the start of this month, the start of the topic, and start taking those small but important steps in filling your cup. If you found value in the Lone Doctrine, or if you believe in our mission, we would be so grateful for your support. We've partnered up with Patreon, a place where you as a supporter can become a patron in helping us stay on air and keep fighting the good fight. By becoming a Patreon, you make today better than yesterday. Visit patreon.com/lonedoctrine, patreon.com/lonedoctrine, or the link in the show notes. There's a great quote, "Be a fountain, not a drain," and we hope to be able to continue to be your fountain of food for thought. The exchange in your support not only results in good vibes, but anything and everything goes towards the betterment of our mission. Thank you so much for your consideration, and an extra thank you to our current Patreons, and we hope to see you over at patreon.com/lonedoctrine. Thank you for tuning in, and if you liked this episode and know of someone else that may benefit from our food for thought, we'd love if you'd share this episode. It would mean the world to us if you could help get this message and our cause out to as many people as we can, because together, we are better. Or if you have a few seconds, we would love to hear your thoughts. You can leave us a review on iTunes and Apple Podcasts, which in turn helps us show up in the search engines so others in need can find us. I am forever grateful. And until next time, keep fighting the good fight. It's a great day.